It's no time to be shy. No time to be shy at all. Time to speak up, to share right now. Very important. And it's important to note that nobody has to be enlightened. Nobody has to do any. This instant, nobody has to do anything at all. Nothing has to happen here in this world. It's already been overlaid. It's been overlaid from the very beginning with the vision of oneness. The vision of oneness is already present. It's like a gift. The gift is already under the tree. We don't have to do anything. We don't have to be enlightened. All we have to do is open the gift. Open the gift. Doesn't matter what the content of this world is at all. Everything is equally overlaid just as it is. So you can be completely unenlightened. Everyone else can be unenlightened. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter at all. We keep thinking we need to enlighten people. No, no, no. Nobody has to be enlightened. Especially us. We don't have to be. Absolutely not. We just need to have the continuity problem resolved for us. And this overlay of all dreams, regardless of content, with no judgment of content whatsoever, that solves the continuity problem for us. So, good news. Good news. We don't have to be enlightened. We're all trying to improve ourselves, get rid of this and add this and be better. Not necessary. Nothing is necessary. Nothing needs to happen at all. We don't need to be loving or kind, or we don't need to build our resume at all. Our resume, the overlay of all dreaming, doesn't pay any attention to any resume at all. Never has, never will. Totally irrelevant. The issue is continuity, and the vision of oneness is the remedy to the continuity problem, and that's it. Forget about everything else. You don't have to worry about anything else at all. Just feel the burden like shifting off you, like all the stuff in the spiritual path, everything, all this, my gosh, you go through YouTube and all this stuff, doesn't matter. None of it matters. It never mattered in the slightest bit. Whatever has happened in this world, none of it matters at all. And whatever will happen doesn't matter at all. The remedy's already been given. The Prime Creator gave the remedy, boom. The instant Spirit decided to try and be Prime Creator, boom. God the Prime Creator knew, going to be dreaming, continuity problem, boom. Blessed dreams. Spirit's going to be dreaming. The only problem is a continuity problem. And the way to resolve the continuity problem is to give a dream that reminds spirit of reality, and boom, blessing is given. Fixed will, overlaying all dreams that could ever arise without any judgment of content whatsoever. Boom, instantly given. Instantly, as soon as spirit said, picked up the idea, like, hey, I want to try. I want to be Prime Creator. Got the Prime Creator. That same instant, blessed all dreams, overlaid the blessing upon all dreaming, all hypotheticals. All hypotheticals were given this vision of oneness. All hypotheticals, vision of oneness, right there, solves the continuity problem. Spirit awakes and realizes, I was only dreaming, and none of that was necessary at all. Instantly. So it's super important to realize that God has never paid any attention to any of the dreaming. Imagine, why would the Prime Creator pay attention when the Spirit says, hey, I think I'm going to dream a dream of usurping the position of Prime Creator? And is the Prime Creator going to say, oh my God, I better pay attention to this dream. I got to follow these dreams. I got to figure out what's going on. No, not at all. No, God knows it's just a dream. It can never be real. Continuity problem is going to be the only issue. Give a blessing of oneness that reminds us of reality. That's it. Never paid any attention to any content of dreaming. Content of dreaming is unimportant. Even the dream that you're enlightened is unimportant. All content of dreams is unimportant. Only that everything be overlaid without exception is the only issue that resolves a continuity problem. Everything overlaid. Overlay those who are enlightened, overlay those who are unenlightened, overlay everything. It doesn't matter what the content is. So we don't have to be enlightened. That's not necessary. Nobody needs to be enlightened. Whatever that may be, it's not necessary. That's not the issue. The issue is don't make an exception. Is be willing to not have any exception made. be willing to see the vision of oneness where no exception is being made. That's the only issue. The only issue. And then you're not enlightened. You're simply accepting the resolution of a continuity problem. That's all. That's the only issue. It doesn't matter to God what the content of dreams are. It doesn't matter to spirit what the content of dreams are. The only issue is to drop all dreaming. The good, the bad, and the ugly. Set it all down. Don't need any of it. That's the only issue. How are we going to do that if we don't remember reality and feel that this is going to be a smooth transition? We don't want an abrupt transition. We want a smooth transition. So that's the only issue there is. And you can just shed all spiritual teachings, everything. Just shed it all. Just sweep off to the side. Let it be. Let it go. Let it go. It's not important. It's not necessary. It's not relevant. There's nothing that anyone needs to do for themselves, for you, for anything. The overlay is already there. Just open it up. Open the pattern. Just see it. Just see it. That's all we have to do is just see it. Just accept it. No exception. No exception. Remember, the blessing is not judging content at all. That's not the point. So you say, well, how can this terrible person be blessed? It's just as blessed as this saint or something. That's not the point. It's not that point. The point is that everything is equally blessed. There's no judgment at all upon dreams. That's the point. No judgment doesn't mean having positive judgment upon something. It means no judgment. So we're trying to be enlightened. We're trying to say, hey, we want God to have a positive judgment on something here. No, there's no judgment on dreams. The more we try to be enlightened, the more we're trying to get some kind of positive judgment on our dreaming. The blessing, the vision of oneness has already been there from the very beginning, and it gives no judgment at all upon the dream. No judgment. That's what we have to accept. But we don't need to become a saint. Nobody needs to become a saint. Nobody needs to try and get some good judgment on dreaming. Nobody needs to get some bad judgment on dreaming. You know, there are those who are trying very much to get a bad judgment on the dreaming, hoping that'll end it. We'll say, oh, God doesn't like this dreaming. Okay, let's set it down. So they're acting out in what we call bad ways, and others are trying to get good judgment on dream, trying to be saints. Some are trying to be saints, some are trying to be sinners, but all trying to get a judgment on the dream. No, the remedy is no judgment on the dream. No judgment, one way or the other, none, no judgment. Just an all-inclusiveness. So we can forget about trying to be good or trying to be bad or trying to be sometimes good, sometimes bad, sometimes to be indifferent or in between or compromise or whatever. Blah, blah, blah. We're trying to do all this stuff, get a judgment on a dream. We don't need any judgment. No judgment required. Some people say, well, it's no mind. No, it's no judgment. The mind is still there. It's no judgment. Don't need any judgment on dreams. We don't need to judge dreams at all. They simply never happened. Why do we need to judge something that never happened? Why do we need to judge a hypothetical that can never happen? There's no need for it at all. You know, what if this could happen? Why judge a hypothetical? It's just, all we need to say is we don't need hypotheticals. So let's set them down. And then there's a continuity issue, so let's set them down because we have a vision of oneness where nothing is excluded, and that reminds us of reality. It's that simple. Take all the spiritual teaching and the history of the universe and poof, dump it into the dumper, because it's really this simple. the vision of no judgment. And we say, whoa, wait a minute, what happened to my judgment? See, that's where we're feeding. We think that we're going to be saved through exercising right judgment. Or getting God to judge the dream. That's what we're trying to do. We're trying to get God to judge the dream. Say, come on, God, we're all waiting for God. Come on, God, you can do it. You can do it. Judge the dream. Come on, just give us a judgment on the dream. Just let us know how you feel about it, you know. And is it good? Is it bad? Are you kind of bored? What? Just give me some feedback. Now, the Prime Creator has never paid any attention to the dream. Why? Why should reality pay attention to a dream? It has no bearing on reality whatsoever. None. So what we need to find out is God has no judgment on the dream at all. And that reminds us, oh, that reminds us of reality. Oh, yeah, that's what reminds us. Oh, reality's not bothered by dreams. Reality doesn't need to pay any attention to dreams. Why does reality need to pay attention to dreams? It doesn't need to pay attention to dreams. Reality doesn't need to pay attention to dreams at all. So what we're really looking for is non-judgment from God. Not from us, but from the Prime Creator. The blessing is not coming from us. It's coming from the Prime Creator saying, no judgment. No judgment. No judgment here. All one. Nothing excluded from this no judgment. This overlay of unconditional peace and stillness and joy and bliss. Unconditional love. Just no judgment. There's no judgment here. No need for any judgment. That reminds us of reality. Is reality judging itself? Is there any judgment in reality? No. It's flawless, it's perfect. There's never any judgment at all in reality. So how can judgment remind us of reality? Even a good judgment. God says, oh, some of you are doing so good. I'm so pleased. You're so wonderful. And those others, oh boy, you know, they're really having troubles. No, that's not it. We just have assumed all this stuff. We've put all these words into God's mouth. We're very good at that. We're all very good at putting words into God's mouth and thinking it, and then God giving back to us what we want to hear. The words we want to hear, we put in God's mouth and we think they're coming back, but we're just imagining all that. God has no judgment on dreaming whatsoever, none. No interest whatsoever, no attention whatsoever, no judgment. It's just God knows there's no necessity for hypotheticals whatsoever, none. So, no need to judge it at all. So what we need is not a positive judgment, it's no judgment. And the no judgment comes in the form of a dream of total oneness, no exclusion whatsoever, no exceptions whatsoever, no judgment whatsoever upon any of it. And this reminds us of reality, and we're willing to set down dreams from that point. But we're not worried about setting down the dream, all dreaming. We're concerned about accepting the resolution of the continuity issue. So in my examining of spiritual teachings, spiritual teachers, all this stuff, I find that this is not emphasized enough. This is not emphasized enough. There are kind of efforts here and there, but cut through to this utter simplicity of it. And that is where you feel like, hey, this is doable. This is really doable. I mean, wow, this is really easy and simple. We have to get to that point where we see it as easy and simple before we're going to accept it. It's like, nothing needs to be judged. There's no judgment. There's a vision of no judgment. Oh, how nice is that? What a relief. You know, we don't lose our mind. We're just not using our mind for the purpose of judgment. That's all. We're so equated with judgment, we think when we're not judging, that we've lost our mind. There's no mind, or the state of no mind. No, it's the state of no judgment. It's the experiencing of oneness without exception, unjudged, no judgment of this is more reserving, and this is less. No, none of that. And maybe we'll shed some tears. We think, oh my gosh, we made all this, all our dreams, our hypothetical fantasies. We made stuff to be good. We made stuff to be bad, and all this. And now it's not, no judgment on any of it. Oh, we want to be judged. We want it to be judged. We want God to say, "Wow, this is very consequential for reality. I need to weigh in here with my judgment." No, it's totally inconsequential to reality. Always has been. Always will be. God doesn't weigh in at all, except with the blessing of oneness, blessing of no judgment. No judgment. And this is what needs to be emphasized right now. We have to cut through all everything, boom. We have to get there right now because the world is going to hell in a handbasket, even as we speak, and has been for a long time. And we cannot sit around, you know, I'm getting impatient with some of the, I watched some videos of the past, spiritual teachers and the questioning, maybe years ago or something. And I just say, wow, this is just all, come on. What is this? And yet at that time, it seemed very profound, but it was slow. God, it's just the intellect asking questions. And the guru will say something. You are not the body. The self. Who cares about the self? Who cares about the body? Who cares about all this stuff? Forget it. Totally, and that's a, what a waste of time that was. My God, you look back, retrospect, what a waste of time. Oh, shoot. Because we're waiting for the judgment. We say, I want to see how God judges this dream. God doesn't judge the dream, never will, never has and never will. So we're waiting for what's never going to happen. How long is that going to take? And yet we have to go through the motions like we're interested in awakening or something. All right, now what is the body? What is the self? What is the self? Tell me about the self. The self. The self. Forget about the self. The self. Forget about the self. We need to solve the continuity problem. That's the issue, not the self. Continuity problem's already been solved. We need to accept it. Vision of not, no judgment, vision of oneness. That's what we need. That's what is needed. Spirit needs to experience that, to abide in that. That's all that's needed. Spirit doesn't need any explanations or about the self or the body or our consciousness or awareness or the world or blah, 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 blah. All that stuff is just delaying tactics, waiting for God to respond to the dream, like God's a little worried. You know, we're hoping that God's a little worried, like God needs to judge something, meaning that we're getting somewhere. This is a prologue to something, meaning all this stuff is meaningful. It's a prologue to actually taking over spot of prime creator. It's no prologue to anything. It's no prologue to anything at all. Just waste of time sitting here waiting. And as we wait, we pretend to be interested in whatever the gurus say is supposed to be something spiritual. Talking and so the self, we say, hey guru, I got a question. So like when you go to sleep, like what happens to the self, or where is my consciousness when I'm resting, or is it aware? And oh yeah, well, what's aware of the awareness? And as we waiting, we say, well, this is a good way to wait, spend our time waiting this way. Some people wait by go climbing mountains or something. It's all the same waiting. It's all people waiting by Epicureans. Let's go to a restaurant tonight. Another one. Restaurant. Food. Everybody's just waiting in their own way. All the spiritual dialogue, that's just waiting too. It's just another form of waiting. All forms of waiting are the same. They're just waiting for some judgment. We're waiting for some feedback. We're waiting to, you know, we're waiting for this prologue to keep moving on, moving forward. We're waiting for something to happen. We're waiting for God to be interested and say, hey, this is consequential. Wow, I better pay attention. This is consequential. We keep saying, hey, okay, if we just do something else, maybe we just get some other, the world does this or that. Maybe God will finally say, oh my gosh, this is consequential. I better pay attention. No, that's all in vain. We're waiting in vain. We're just waiting in vain. We just need to accept this. We've just been waiting here, and some of us wait by asking spiritual questions. That's just a form of waiting, too. I mean, it's amazing. In hindsight, looking back, you can see, my gosh, this stuff is just a form of waiting. It's just a delaying tactic, just the same as any other. Just the same as any other, really. With the slight difference, maybe, of that you might come into contact with the real truth as you're asking questions. It might seep in, but usually they avoid that, and it doesn't seep in, really. It depends what your motivation is, of course. If you really, really, really want to get to it, then you don't want to hear that stuff, really. My response to all the questions and satsang is just, I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. Forget it. Waste of time. But we all have to make nice here, right? So I don't want to say anything. I never wanted to say anything. I was like, I better not say anything. I really want to just say, forget it. Forget all this talk. Forget it. Just get right to the resolution of the continuity issue right now, this instant. Nothing needs to happen. It's already been there. But to make nice, be quiet. Don't say anything. Okay. All right, everything. Just be nice. Don't rock the boat. Be nice. Because these people are very earnest. They're very earnest into, the self. How does the self relate to this? And da-da-da-da. Trying to figure it all out. How do you figure no judgment out? How is that figured out? How do we figure out no judgment, vision of no judgment? How do we figure it out? We think, well, what about the self? What about the mind? What about this? What about consciousness? Where? What about that? Trying to figure out no judgment. Okay, no judgment. What is that? Well, forget it. I can't relate to that. Can't relate to no judgment. I got to figure out what the right judgment is. And so it's just a game. It's just a waiting game. It's just a game. All this stuff is just a game, really. It's just a game. And we need to accept it. Yeah, we've just been engaged in a game of delay. Most of the gurus I've seen in the world are, for my opinion, are just part of that game, with notable exceptions. There are some that actually have accepted the vision of no judgment. There have been some of those. Yes. Others not. They're still playing the game of explanation about all this and this and this and this and this. And it's like we all have to make nice to one another. It's late in the game. It's too late in the game for that. It's too late in the game for that. Okay, here we are. It's too late in the game. We gotta stop making nice about all that stuff and just say, really, forget it. Let's just admit, hey, we were just playing a waiting game, all right? That's all. People ask you, well, what did you figure out? What did you figure out? I mean, you got the answer. What's the self? What's it? No. That was just a waiting game. I was just playing a waiting game. None of that was important at all. None of it. Just a waiting game. They don't need to answer any of that stuff. Now, most people watching these videos, they are realizing that they will accept the vision of non-judgment and wake up, and they'll have to share that with others. So you're thinking, how do I share this? How do I share? Don't need to answer any of those questions. Don't have to answer any of those questions. I'll just say, forget it. Forget about enlightenment. By all means, forget about enlightenment. Forget about the self. Forget about all spiritual teaching. Forget about it. That's just a waiting game. It's just a waiting game. And it's a way to appear superior as you're doing the waiting game from most part of, a lot of it. They say, hey, I'm very intelligent because I'm asking a question about the self. What happens to the self when you are in deep sleep? Or what happens to the self? I'm very intelligent. That's just a waiting game. None of that's relevant. None of it's relevant. Okay, so it's a way of avoiding the remedy to the continuity issue by pretending to be engaged with something that is very, very, very deep and important. It's not deep, it's not important. Forget about it. So people come to you and they're gonna ask you, what happened? I accepted the vision of not judgment, vision of oneness. No judgment. No judgment of content whatsoever. And lo and behold, I have this deep sense of remembrance and gratitude. Like it's something, it's a feeling that is indescribable. It's an indescribable feeling. And that's remembrance of reality is seeping in. Say, hey, this vision of oneness is reminding me of something really fantastic and wonderful. And it's just seeping in, but it's indescribable. You know, no need to describe. That's it. You didn't figure out the self or the one. Don't need to figure anything out. Just accept this blessing on dreams, the solution to the continuity problem. Say, one problem is a continuity problem. This vision of oneness, of non-judgment, solves the continuity problem, and that's it. We've just been dreaming, and this will enable us to set all dreams down. Keep it as simple as possible. Simple as possible. And people right now have got to recognize it's time to cut through all the junk. Throw the junk away. Even the good junk. All the pretty junk. Throw it away. Forget about it. It served its purpose, which was delay. Don't need to read any more books. We don't need to be reading books. We need to be experiencing vision of oneness. We don't need to be reading books. We don't need to be meditating. We don't need to be doing anything except experiencing it, directly experiencing vision of oneness. That's it. That's all we need to do right now. That's all we ever needed to do. But we better do that right now. Otherwise, we're going to get swept away by activism. Of meaning, let's make something better, which means let's get rid of what is not so good. Of course, if you're making something better, are you not getting rid of what's not so good? Of course you are. The whole idea of better is what you have now is not good enough. So when you make it better, what's going to happen to what you have now? If you're not going to have it, you're going to throw it in the garbage. So you're judging what's better. We don't need judgment. In reality, we're not judging what's better. We're not saying, hey, this is better than this. Let me see, is this better than this? And, no. It's all one. It's all one. We don't need judgment. The mind doesn't need judgment. The mind keeps saying, oh, judgment is the mind. No, it's not. It's a hypothetical. The mind saying, what if I needed to judge? The mind doesn't need to judge. Mind doesn't need judgment. We don't need judgment. But we don't want to set dreams down yet because we're afraid of a continuity issue. So have a dream of non-judgment. Very simple. Very simple. Meets all our requirements. Mind doesn't need to judge, but we're so used to dreams, we don't want to quite set dreams down yet. So let's have a dream of non-judgment. And then we'll say, hey, you know what? I can set judgment down. And I can also set dreams down. And okay, no problem. No problem. So we got to do it. We got to keep pushing on. It has to happen. It has to happen fast. And we got to be encouraged and reassured. Say, yes, we can do this. Absolutely, we can. We can accept the vision of non-judgment right now. Right now, right now, right now. Yes, we can accept the vision of non-judgment. Vision of oneness, vision of non-judgment. And let that dawn very soon, very quickly. And by doing a video like this, it's helpful. It's helpful for me, it's helpful for you, it's helpful for everyone. Is at least there's something available like this that is just bringing it, you know, coming on strong. You got to come on strong. I don't know what these people are doing in the world. They think they have all the time in the world to talk about the self or something. Come on, do not be aware of the times we live in right now. We do not, the push to make things better is going to become extreme in this world. It already is extreme, but it's going to exponentially, quantum leap in extremeness of being pulled into that. The mind will insist this has to be done. We have to make it better because God hasn't judged it yet. We need that judgment. And so there'll be a huge push. And of course, making things better means getting rid of what you judge to be not as good, which means trouble. So we can't talk about the self anymore. Cannot do it. Forget it. It's over. That's over. That's finished. That was finished on December 21st, 2012. That's what finished. We're not going to talk about the self and consciousness and blah, 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 blah anymore. We don't have any more time for that. We wasted enough time already. We need to directly accept the vision of oneness, the vision of non-judgment. Directly experience it right now. Right now. That's it. And we need to feel this. We need to feel, hey, yeah, that is right. Hey, yeah, yeah, we need to do this. We need to feel it. We need to accept that all this talk is over. It's over. It's over. It's over. It's over. It is over. And we need affirmations and reassurance that, yes, we only need to do this, nothing else. So when someone comes to you and says, explain to me, forget about explanations. No, we're not explaining. Simplicity of it, which I'm giving out continuously, that you can easily also give out. And you can. It's so simple. It's the only problem. We don't want to set all dreams down abruptly. So we dream of non-judgment, which is the way to set dreams down. They're all equally meaningless. No necessity to them, ever. And that also reminds us of reality doesn't need to be judging itself at all. So that's it. Very simple, really, explanations. And you know I can give those. I've been giving them out continuously. It's not any problem at all. But you can do it in 5 minutes, 3 minutes. The basics, just boom, boom, boom. It's very simple. Accept the vision of oneness, the vision of non-judgment. No judgment of content. Just equal overlay, no judgment of content. Just abide in that. And the more we are able to enunciate this, the closer we get. Just by doing a video like this and putting it out there in the world, you know, sending shockwaves, people say, hey, yeah, that's right. Hey, wow, we need to do this. Wow, what have I been doing? I've been spending all this time, yabba yabba yabba, as far as asking questions, one question leading to another question. We have to get to the state that's beyond questioning. We don't need any questions. There's no judgment. Why do we need questions? We're not judging. The vision of no judgment, there's no questions there. No need to ask any questions. That answers all questions. It answers all questions. Continuity problems, the only problem we have. Vision of non-judgment is the way. The continuity problem is resolved. Boom. There are no questions. Not really. Not real questions. What about? Nah, those are whatabouts. Forget about whatabouts. We don't have time for whatabouts. That's delaying tactic too. The content of dreams doesn't matter. Content of dreams does not matter because dreams do not affect the dreamer in any way. We are the dreamer. Spirit is the dreamer. Content of dreams does not affect the dreamer. And we have to be reminded of that. And the vision of non-judgment reminds us of that. Vision of oneness reminds the dreamer that content of dreams doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. We're not affected by our dreaming. And that is what we need to be reassured. We need to be reassured of that. We're a little afraid to set all dreaming down and say, what if some of those dreams of death might have corrupted me or something? No, they haven't corrupted anyone. No aspect of spirit has been touched by any dreams. No one. You can get the craziest dreams and darkest, vicious dreams possible, and that does not affect the dreamer in the slightest bit. But we need to be reassured of that. We have to be reassured of that. We feel it's a little too risky. Continuity problem. Say, wait a minute. I suddenly realize that I'm completely untouched by dreams. What? I thought I was going, might be touched by them. What do I do? It's a little, we got this trepidation in us. Like, think, wow, maybe we have hurt ourselves, or maybe we've hurt reality. We need to be reassured ahead of time. No. We've not been untouched by anything. This blessing of non-judgment is totally unconcerned with the content of dreams. Totally unconcerned with it. Doesn't matter in the slightest bit what the dreams have been, good or bad. It doesn't judge good or bad or whatever, anything. It doesn't judge at all. No judgment, non-judgment. Then that reassures us, obviously the Prime Creator is not the slightest bit concerned about the content of dreams. And I'm remembering, I've just been dreaming, and that it's not affected the Prime Creator. If it hasn't affected the Prime Creator, it hasn't affected me, because the Prime Creator's will is fixed. And I'm a creation of the Prime Creator, so I haven't been affected in any way either. We get reassured about this, and then we're willing to set dreams down altogether. So a little bit of explanation. We're a little explanation, but it needs to loop back. Right, always loop back to experience the vision of oneness, the vision of non-judgment right now, this instant, right here, right now, no exception. Right here, right now, no exception. It always loops back to that. Teaching has to loop back to that, back to affirmations, right here, right now. I accept the vision of oneness, the vision of non-judgment, right here, right now. No exceptions. I know there's no exceptions. God's will is fixed, and that is my salvation. God's will is fixed, and that is my salvation. Vision of non-judgment is here this very instant with me. Vision of non-judgment is here, is always with me this very instant. I don't need any time to do it. Because it's not judging the concept of time at all, so there's no judgment on time at all. If you're not judging anything that arises in time, time is not being judged, so you don't need time. You don't say, well, this moment, next moment might be better. No, it's non-judgment. So this next moment or the previous moment are totally irrelevant, right? So we don't have to get stuck in the past or the future. Don't have to be stuck there. Because there's no judgment at all upon dreaming. So previously there was no judgment. In the future there'll be no judgment. There's no judgment now. So we don't have to be stuck in time. Like, maybe I better wait and I'll get a better judgment. Or, oh my gosh, I missed the time when I would have got good judgment. How do I get back to that? You see, we're being caught between the past and the future. No, there's no need for any of that. No need for any of that. Perfect non-judgment is with me right now. It's always with me right now. There is no judgment at all, so how can it not be with me right now? It's not caught in time. It's not caught in time at all. So this is what we have to adamantly tell ourselves, which is what I'm doing here in this video, showcasing it for you, of where a good place for you to be right now is along these lines. Of course, you'll have your own unique expression of it. But the adamancy of it, the urgency of it, the nowness of it, the importance of it, to drop everything else. Just drop it. It's not being judged. Drop it because it's not being judged. Is this being judged? No. Drop. Is this? Drop it. No. Is questions about the self being judged? No. Drop it. Is anything being judged? No. Just set it down. Is this day, this moment being judged? No. Is tomorrow being judged? No. Has any time in the past, anything I've done in the past being judged? No. That can be dropped too. Nothing I've ever dreamed in the past, nothing that I ever will dream in the future, none of that is being judged. So, set it all down. Totally unnecessary to pay any attention to it. It's junk. It's just junk. You don't have to get rid of it. Just set it down. It's just junk. You don't need to pay attention to it. It doesn't serve a purpose. It's useless. Now, after these videos, what happens to me? I'm tired, because it's like ice breaking. It's like breaking ice. It crunch. It's like the harbor is frozen in, and I have to plow through this ice, and so it's exhausting, because I have to say things that most others are not saying, and I have to bring a new, fresh urgency to the whole situation. I have to break free of the inertia. There's all this spiritual inertia. It's all waiting for God to say, to judge in some way. It's all inertia. There's so much inertia. I just go through all the channels and people and the teachers, and there's inertia, and I have to like say, okay, I just got to break through this, got to break through it. So of course I feel like my nerves, I'm tired. I need to rest. I sleep. I say, I got to rest. It's tiresome. And then I feel like, I can't do it anymore. I'm too tired. It's too exhausting. It's too difficult. But then if I rest, and then I say, well, let me give it one more try. That's what's needed right now. Of course, if you're doing this, you're going to feel some fatigue, because your nerves are a little bit jangled, because you just say, whoa, I'm sort of stepping out of familiar territory of the inertia, of the waiting game, figuring everything out. Nothing we need to figure out except just the clear basics. Continuity problem is the only problem we have. God has already provided us with the resolution of the continuity problem. All we have to do is accept that resolution. It's the vision of oneness, the vision of non-judgment that reminds us of reality. And that's it. And then we can settle dreaming down. Why are we dreaming? Because we wanted to be prime creator. In order to be prime creator, we'd have to change reality. If we want to change reality, reality would have to be annihilated, because reality is one indivisible whole. So we're trying to figure out how can we survive the annihilation of reality. We need a new identity. This new identity would need to dwell in some other reality. You know, we need to create a new reality, a new identity, a new reality. What if all this could happen? What if? Those are all dreams. Total non-necessity, any of them. No need for any of them ever. Just a contingency plan that will never be needed. How can we survive the annihilation of reality? It's a contingency plan. We don't need it. We don't need dreams. Dreams are completely meaningless. Just what ifs. What if? What if what could never take place took place? Could take place. It's that. What if what could never ever take place could take place? That is literally what we are dreaming about. That's it. Nothing more than that. All the complexity and all the da 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 da, those are just caught up in hypotheticals and reason of plausibility. Plausibility just churns all this stuff out. What if this were this, then we could do this, and what if that were that, and what if? You just get lost in dreams of what if. You're just constantly churning what if. Meaningless, all completely meaningless. Totally unnecessary. That's why no judgment. God gives no judgment on it whatsoever. Except equal blessing. Like God saying, hey, everything's still perfect. That's basically, God's just giving a blessing. Like, everything is still perfect. This blessing is perfect. Just look at the blessing. It's a perfect blessing. See? Doesn't exclude anything. It's not judging anything. This non-judgmental, perfect blessing. Everything in reality is still perfect. Don't worry. That's all it is. And so, The effort is to drop everything else. Set it down. And that's the effort I'm engaged in, the effort you're engaged in, the effort everyone's engaged in. And yet we have to speed it up. If there's anything I can do in the world, it's to push this. Push. Speed it up. Beautiful evening tonight, but the bad weather is returning for the next 2 weeks. See? That's when we think that now we've turned the corner. Oh, the bad stuff comes back. So the world seems to be getting a breather. Oh, you know, but don't be surprised if everything starts accelerating like crazy coming up. And then people are shouting, please God, give us a good judgment. Please judge the bad, the wicked. Get rid of the wicked. We're so traumatized by the wicked, and please rain your judgment down upon this. You know, wow. That's just off the tracks entirely. What God does is rains not judgment down upon all equally. Rains non-judgment down. So when you pray, say, God, rain down your non-judgment on all. that should be the song. Rain down your non-judgment on all. See, that's what we should be praying for. So that's what we should be praying for. Rain down your non-judgment on all. It's already there. That rain is already falling. That rain. Just imagine if there was this beautiful rain falling everywhere. It's already falling. It is there. It's just we don't see it because we don't want to see it because we're denying it. But it's there. The non-judgment is raining down equally on all. This beautiful non-judgment is raining down everywhere. And you can symbolize it, describe it any which way you want to. You know, everyone seems to have their own notion of how to describe it, etc. But that doesn't really matter. But whatever is useful, whatever is helpful. I mean, I just thought of that one up like that. I never thought of that before, but actually seeing this beautiful, soft rain raining down on everything, touching everything equally. Doesn't rain do that already? Doesn't rain come down on the just and unjust alike? Isn't that what Jesus was telling us? Absolutely it was. Judge not, lest ye be judged. Lest you believe in judgment. And believing in judgment doesn't solve the continuity problem. Because it believes that dreams are somehow consequential to reality, and they're not. So, let the rain come down on all leaves, all the leaves, all the dusty ground, all the people, everything, everywhere. Let this beautiful rain of light rain down upon everything. Maybe we'll dream that. Maybe we'll tonight we'll go to sleep and we'll dream of this beautiful rain. Or you can say snow, beautiful snow flakes just gently coming down on everything. Rain, whatever you want. Sunlight or some kind of light, just light beams gently coming down and touching everything, or everything being self-illumined, radiating this beautiful light, or all sorts of ways that you can symbolize it. To rehearse it. So we have shifted gears here, which was the whole struggle from December 21st, 2012 to this point, which is February 16th, which is it's about two months period, which was a transition period. I realize this is going to be a transition period. It's going to be very tough, and we have to do it. And we have done it. We are doing it, and we have done it. We have shifted gears here, which is necessary. Absolutely necessary. I told you, 2013, we have to shift gears. We have to find a new gear, and this is the new gear. This is the new type of talk. This is the kind of talk that is needed in 2013, and beyond that is the actual acceptance of this beautiful reign of non-judgment and oneness upon all. The actual abiding in that is in the cards for us. It is in the cards. When will it happen? I don't know. But certainly, we need to make this shift in emphasis. Shifting gears means a shift in emphasis. We're shifting to this more urgent, adamant, affirmation-driven, real strong emphasis right here, boom, like that. We're shifting to that. And so the way I talk is more pointed, more adamant. It has to be super adamant, like a cheerleader. Come on, right now, you got to... You got to accept the vision of non-judgment, because that's what we need to hear right now. For you, and you know it too. You know it. Those who are aware, they realize we're up against it. We are up against it. We're dealing with retroactive law, changes in law that are become retroactive. We're up against the pressure to become activists, to get rid of, to get something better, to get rid of what's not so good. We're under that pressure. We're under the gun. We are severely under the gun. Severely. More severely than we know. So, for those who realize that, it's not difficult to accept this style of adamant urgency, saying, do it now, you gotta do it now. Gotta do it now. That should be welcome talk to ears. Maybe our ears aren't quite used to it now, but we will get used to it very quickly. Just forget about everything else. Forget about everything else. Forget about it. Not need it. No longer need it. Set it all down. Set it all down. Gently set it down with gratitude, but set it down now. And that's what I've been doing too. I've been doing that too. I've been looking at some teachers and some mentors that I've been following in certain ways, getting a little help here, a little help there, and now I'm saying, hey, wait a minute. That was so 2012-ish, right? This is 2013. We are in a new phase. We are in a new phase entirely right now. That we were aware it's coming, but it is here. And we have to use a different type of talk and a different type of walk right now. We can't wait. We got to do it right now. So the other stuff, it's out of fashion already. It is out of fashion, and you just have to accept it. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much. But it's out of fashion right now. So I don't go back and listen to my videos. Forget it. That's out of fashion. It's out of fashion. It's no longer that useful. It's not useful anymore. It's not useful anymore. Right now, 2013, we need to drop everything except the vision of non-judgment, vision of oneness. We need to abide in that gentle rain that is raining down on all equally. Judging it what it's falling upon at all. No judgment. And we only need to get the feeling of this rain, the feeling of no judgment at all upon anything. Doesn't matter. It's not judging what it's falling upon. It's not judging it. We need to pay attention to that. Just pay attention to that. Sure, everything is still here in the world. Don't pay attention. That's not important. It's the non-judgment that's important. And somehow this needs to be symbolized in a dream format. All dreams are symbols. So somehow this is symbolized for us. And we pay attention to that. That is what is called for right now, this moment, this instant. And going forward, there's no going back right now. There's no going back. We are in this phase now. We are in this phase now. Past is gone. Forget it. Passé. We're in this phase. Which is fine. It's fine. It's fine. I'm fine with it. No problem whatsoever. And you know, you get used to this, and you'll feel fine with it too. And you will just marvel, you know, at the past. Say, oh my gosh, you look back. Say, oh my gosh. I'm sure glad I'm where I'm at now. That I'm right on the emphasis now. And we are actually stepping into this vision, as it were, accepting it. Just one minute. Hey, yeah.
Are you family?
Huh?
Are you gay?
No.
Oh, I'm just finna say.
No.
Okay, have a good one, babe.
You too. I should have left that one on, my gosh. Holy cow. I should have left that one on. That's amazing what just happened. Wow. Holy cow. Well, I stood up to that one. My gosh. I switched off there. I switched off, okay. Someone was knocking at the door, and I said, hello, hello, hello. I switched off, and then someone came over here and said, wow, I'm selling magazines. I want some of your time. And I just said, no, I'm engaged. I'm Skyping. I'm talking to people, whatever. And we had a back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And they said, I'll come back later, I'll come back later, I'll come back later. I said, no, I don't think so. I'm not interested. No, 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 no. And they said, well, I'll look you up online. Are you famous? Are you famous? And they said, well, if you're famous, I'll come back later if you're famous. And I said, no, I'm not famous. And and then as they're leaving, they say, are you family? Are you family? Are you family? I say, huh? And they say, what are you talking about? I say, are you gay? And I said, no. And they said, oh, okay, okay. I thought, okay, okay. I said, holy cow. My gosh. Interesting stuff, huh? But I stood firm. I said, no. I'm engaged with something else. I'm engaged with something else. That was like maximum pressure, believe me. Maximum pressure is a black woman. Here's a black woman. And maximum pressure. And she tried to look at the screen. Hey, what are you doing? What are you doing? Oh, look at your setup. Let me know. I said, no, I just, you know, no, no, no. I'm just not interested. That was intense pressure right there. Intense. I was able to handle it. I'm kind of like breaking continuity right there, huh? Big break in continuity. Wow. Big break in continuity. Kaboom. I had a feeling Saturday night, this neighborhood gets hit out, getting hit with people. She said, can I come back later tonight? I say, no. No, you cannot. I'm not. I'm engaged. I'm engaged. I cannot come back. I come back sometime, some other time. I said, no, no, I'm not really interested. You see? First time I've ever been able to do that. I always say, oh, okay, okay, okay. I said, no, now, no, 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 no. I should have left it on. I should have left it on, son of a gun. You would have gotten a big kick out of that. But anyway, it's okay. Maybe she didn't want to be on camera or have her voice on camera, so it's okay. But you see, the push, the activism, the push, hey. You see how it works. Going door to door now. Boom, 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 boom. Hey, basically, hey, are you activist? Are you activated? Let me activate you. Let me activate you. Right? Let me activate you. I'm here to activate you. Hey, you might even be family. I'm here to activate you. I said, ah, no, thank you. I don't want to be activated. I want to be deactivated. I want to be deactivated. All right? Deactivated. I want the vision of non-judgment, which is totally deactivated, right? And yet it's blissful, completely blissful. Completely blissful. But maybe I need to move to a gated community where you don't have these swarms of people knocking on your door saying, are you activated yet, honey? Let me activate you. Let me activate you, you see. You need to be activated. No, I don't. I basically say, no, I don't. 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 You see. I need to be deactivated. Be deactivated. She says, I want to look you up online. I said, no, I'm not giving out my online-ness identity. No, I'm not. So I'm not giving it out. Wow, you see, they want to check you out. What are you doing? Are you an activist? Oh, let me check you out. No, I'm a deactivist. I'm into deactivation. Oh, better write that down and put you on the list. Maybe I'll come back later and try you later. No, you no, don't bother trying me later. That kind of got into the mood, didn't it? Yeah, a little bit. I'm wondering if they're still hovering around. I don't know. Didn't really hear them leave, but hopefully they did. Don't worry about coming back later. No, we are stepping into the beautiful reign of non-judgment and the total deactivation of judgment, you see. And we are staying in that reign. We're not stepping out of it and saying, okay, we've had that, now let's get back to activism. We're not going to fall for any of that, honey. I want to activate you. No, I don't want to be activated. nice lady. But, you know. But, right? Full of the energy of I want to activate you. Come on, I can activate you. Yes, I can. No, you cannot. Not interested in that. Interested in being deactivated. So I said, no, you cannot come back later tonight. No, you cannot come back later any time. Not interested. Forget it. First time I've ever done that. Hi, kitty. I guess if the cat is comfortable, there's nobody hanging around here. Hey, cat. Looking out after me. Absolutely. Whew. Wow. That was quite a wild situation. I mean, this person had energy coming off, but it was the energy of activation. I've got a lot of energy push coming off of me, but it's to get right emphasis, you see. Deactivation. Experience the reign of non-judgment. That's different. That's a different direction. All right. So we're not soulmates, soul brothers, and anything. No, we're not. We're going in different directions. We're all one in reality, of course. But as far as practical, as far as dreams go, we're going in different directions. One is a dream of non-judgment. One is a dream of judgment. Two different directions. So we'll have to catch them on the flip side, as it were. Holy cow. Holy smokes. I could paint a picture for you with just what happened. Wow. My gosh. Never seen so much pink in my life. Pink here, pink there, pink. Okay. Oh my goodness. So, yes indeed. That was a nice test. I passed the test. Thank you. Thank all the viewers. You know, my gratitude is to all the viewers of this channel. Really. Because if it weren't for you, I wouldn't be doing this. And if I weren't doing this, I wouldn't be up to speed. You see? So the fact that some people are willing to at least pay attention to this and consider it is a great blessing for everybody. Not just for me, for everybody. Because whatever progress anyone makes towards accepting the reign of non-judgment is shared with everyone's progress for everyone, actually. For everyone. So everybody is being helped by this, by the taping, by the viewer, the viewing, all of it. Everybody is actually getting a great deal of help. They may not know it because they're still engaged in dreams of judgment, but they are. It will come to them at some point. It will come to them. So thank you to that lady. Blessings to the lady because she gave me this test and I passed it. So wonderful lady. And that blessings will come to her for sure. To everyone. We're not worried. how it comes to everyone. It will come to everyone because our vision of non-judgment is already raining down on everyone. Everyone. It's already there. And how anyone comes to it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter at all. So, if we can keep going. We can keep going. Viewership took a dip during the last 2 months because we're in this transition phase and people are struggling. Everyone is struggling. Absolutely. Understandable. Everyone is saying, whoa, can I really make this transition now? Can I really get into it? Can I really get into another level here? And and so we're struggling. And yes, we can. We can get into another level. So I expect things to pick up. Actually, subscriptions have picked up. Viewership is down. Subscriptions have picked up as people are kind of like getting their second wind. You know, okay, this is 213. Wow. What do I do? Do I really go for it? Yeah, I got to go for it. Okay. It's like that. Getting a second wind and then saying, okay, let's push forward. So, I mean, it's amazing. The subscriptions are over 200 now. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. It was just a little while ago, it was like 180. I said, never get to 180. Now it's over 200. I don't know what happened. So we are going to make this push. We are going to make this push now. We're going to make the push. And it's happening already. And the standing up to that situation I just did was amazing because I had the full blast on me. Full blast right there. Full blast. Everything. Had a gay black woman at nighttime going around door to door, trying with full of zest and personality and energy and conviction, etc., insisting that I have to succumb to that, and I didn't. I didn't. So that's a pretty amazing thing, actually. Very amazing thing. I didn't have a guilt complex. See, the guilt complex didn't kick in. She tried. She was waiting for the guilt complex to kick in. Right? Hey, you know, just waiting, just waiting. She's just waiting, hanging around waiting. It's going to kick in, honey. It's going to kick in. I know it is. I know it is. I know, well, he'll kick in later. I know it'll kick in later. I know. I'll come back later. I say, no, 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 no. It's not going to kick in. It's not going to kick in. Because the rain of non-judgment is raining down on you too, equally, right this instant. So it's your decision. It's not mine. You can decide or for judgment or non-judgment, dream of judgment or dream of non-judgment. There's no guilt on me. There's never been any guilt on me or anyone. There's no guilt. There's no guilt on anybody. So the guilt didn't kick in. The guilt trip didn't kick in. She's like waiting for it to kick in. And she said, well, then try the angle like, hey, maybe you're one of us and we can talk on that level too. And I said, no, I'm not part of the quote unquote, the family. I guess that's what they call now. You're the family, part of the family. And, no, I'm not one. So the guilt trip didn't kick in. None of that stuff kicked in. That's amazing. That's amazing. That's kind of a milestone, really, that it just didn't kick in. It's not there. It's not really there. And again, I have the viewers here to thank for that, actually. Holy Spirit, my spiritual mentors, God the Prime Creator, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, God the Gurus, and the viewership here to thank for that. Ustream and YouTube providing the necessary technology for that. I have that to thank also. Because and myself, thank myself too. It made it possible. So it is possible. I'm telling you, it is possible to stand up to the pressure like that. But thank God for one step ahead. Because if we're one step behind, that's no place to be. There's no place to be. When you're behind the wake of a huge boat, that's no place to be. You're in the wake. You're getting clobbered. You need to be ahead of the boat, not behind it. You need to be in the stem, not in the stern. The bow. The prow. The bow of the boat, not the stern, not the back. You need to be in front of the boat, not in back of the boat. And it's no good to be in back of the boat. Say, well, I'm just a little bit in back of the boat. You're getting the turmoil, all the guilt trip and all the activism, all that stuff. There's no place to be. You got to be in front of the boat. Out ahead of the boat. So it takes work, it takes nerve, it takes push, it takes determination, it takes courage, it takes will. You exercise your will. Say, I will do this, I will do it, I am doing it, you see. And so, very great. Let it be done that way. Gated community. that's going to be helpful. Relocation is even better. Relocation, gated community, relocation. We don't need the pressure of activists trying to activate us right now. No way. No way. But for some reason, I don't have that. We're wide open for the blitzkrieg. It's a blitzkrieg. You know, we talk about the blitzkrieg in World War II. We're under a blitzkrieg right now. It's a different kind of blitzkrieg. It's a blitzkrieg of activism. Activists, they're going door to door to door to door, knock, 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 saying, hey, I'm an activist. Hello, how are you? You're an activist too, aren't you? And I want to help bring you up your activism. So I'm here to help you with that. Would you like to do that right now? Let's do it right now. They would say, oh, no, I'm a non-activist. Oh, really? What? No, I'm not an activist. Oh, something wrong with you, you know. So we don't need that. We don't need that. We don't need that. You must be prejudiced. You must be intolerant. You must be a bigot. You must be something wrong. There's something wrong somewhere. Where's your guilt? Where's your guilt? You know, where's your guilt? No, it's just my intelligence is showing me that accepting the vision of non-judgment is the solution to the continuity problem. That's the only problem I or anyone has. So I want to showcase that for you. It's real activism. That's real activism. Okay, I'm practicing real activism. Hey, how about practice something that actually works? How about that? That's being really a true activist. A true activist. So let's be true activists. And the fake ones, of course, won't like that. Because it'll out them. Talk about outing out of the closet. Out the fake activists out of the closet. They don't want that. They don't want to be outed. They want to stay in the closet of fakery, of the dreams of judgment. They want to stay in that closet. Well, okay, fine. Let them stay. But let's not get all entangled up in each other's hair here, you know. No. So. are you famous? Only two of you. Only two of you people. So is that famous? I don't know. Or infamous. I'm infamous to many. Famous to a few, infamous to many. Even though they don't know it. That infamous activist who was talking about the vision of non-judgment. Ah, what an infamous activist that was. Terrible. Terrible stuff. Let us fix it. Let us twist the story around so it's all okay. Like Jesus. People hated Jesus. Wow, they hate him. And they said, oh my gosh, maybe we shouldn't hate so much. Let's change the story around. Let's twist it this way and that way. And so we can accept and say, oh, now we love you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you for legitimizing sacrifice and all this stuff. Yeah. So, see, of course, they'll twist it around. So they make you turn you into a fake activist retroactively. No, this is real activism here. This is real activism here you're listening to. Be a real activist. You are a real activist because you're listening to this. You are a true activist. An activist for truth. Activist for truth. That is being a true activist, okay? Vision of non-judgment. Let's put it that way. People say vision of Christ. You know, we can say vision of non-judgment, actually. I find that more useful. Vision of non-judgment. Because that's what it is. Vision of oneness. Well, vision of non-judgment is even more to the point. Even more to the point, actually. It really sets home. And you can imagine the rain, this beautiful rain. Soft, beautiful rain with almost like a golden, beautiful, lighted rain, as it were. Pure, fresh rain coming down gently on everything, softly and gently on everything. Not judging what it's falling upon at all. Vision of non-judgment is here right now. It's here for me right now. This very instant, the vision of non-judgment is here with me right now. So, all right, very great. Very great, very great. I got to get back to my diet, a diet of grapefruit juice and seaweed. Because I had to go to restaurants for celebration that, celebrate this, celebrate that. Boom. gained 5 pounds just like that. I said, whoops, that's not good. So now I decided, I'm going to go on a diet of grapefruit juice and seaweed. If I feel hungry, eat some seaweed. If I'm thirsty, drink some grapefruit juice. Pretty much adhered to that with a little bit of oatmeal in the morning and a little bit of tangerines. But I'm getting pretty hungry right now, I'll tell you that. Getting pretty hungry, and the pounds come off. All right, very great. What a recording. Holy smokes. What a time we're in, right? What a time. Don't let the time overwhelm you. Don't let it overwhelm you. Be overwhelmed here first and get used to that and say, hey, I'm not so overwhelmed by this. And then you'll say, you know what, that other stuff, forget it. Piece of cake. Not going to be overwhelmed by that either. And then say, you know what, vision and non-judgment, I can accept that. At least I can consider accepting it. At least I can spend my time considering it. Yeah, let me consider that today. When I get up in the morning, let me consider accepting the vision of non-judgment today. That's when you wake up in the morning, remember that. Today, what am I going to do today? What's my focus going to be? Oh, I think I'll consider the vision of non-judgment today. Yeah, that'll be really great use of time today. I'm going to consider accepting the vision of non-judgment today. I'm going to consider that. Hey, see? That's right use of time. That's being an activist, a true activist, an activist for truth. So today I'm going to be an activist for truth. All that other stuff, no, that's not really being activist at all. I'm going to be a real activist today. I'm going to consider accepting the vision of non-judgment today. Puts everything else in perspective, right? Pushes everything else aside. All this other stuff, activism, which is just like mushrooms, mushrooming everywhere. And it's going to go off the charts, and really. It's coming as off the charts. So push all that aside. Say, hey, I'm being a true activist today, an activist for truth, considering accepting the vision of non-judgment. Right, even today, I'm considering actually accepting it today, not tomorrow, but I'm actually thinking, like, you know what, I might accept it today. So, holy cow. All right. Very great, very great, very great. We can do it. Yes, we can do it. We can shift gears. We have shifted gears. Yes, we can be true activists. Yes, we can get up in the morning and say, I'm going to consider accepting the vision of non-judgment today. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Yes, we will. We will do that. We are doing it. We will do this. All right. Very great. Boom. That's it.